Hey, what's up guys, and welcome to a brand new game series in which I'll be showing you how to make a clicker game in Scratch. Just like this one. Cool start menu, check. Cool button effects, check. Cool counter, check. Cool shop, check. Cool settings, check. And cool cookie, check. Let's get started. In this episode, which is the first episode, we'll be making the cookie, we'll be making the background glow, we'll be making the falling cookies background and the plain background itself. Let's get started. So first go to the link in the description and get the assets for the part 1. And as you can see, I've already imported them. So first one is the cookie. This looks really good. Then we have the background, which is basically the cookie copy and pasted a lot of times. Then we have the cookie glow, which is not visible unless I change its color. Now I think you can see it. It is basically a lot of rays, and then we have a gradient circle, and this is basically in white. Then we have black bars. Let's get started. First of all, name the cookie cookie. Then we can start coding the cookie. So first of all, what we want is a cool clicking effect and also changing the score. So we'll go by when the green flag clicked, hide. Now you may ask, why hide? That is because we'll be starting the game on a broadcast, which you can create and name it start game. Once it is created, you can just, when I receive, start game, and we can script everything here. So we can just start by basic stuff like switch to costume 1, go to front layer and show. And now we can make the clicking effect. So forever, if else, touching mouse pointer, and this will basically detect if the mouse is touching the cookie or not. So when it is touching the cookie, we need to increase its size smoothly, just like this. So to do that, you can just put a simple script like set size to 100. Then you can put some operators in this. First put a plus operator, then put a divide operator, and then put a minus operator, just like this. The plus one should be first, then put the divide one in the second, and then put minus in the middle one, just like this. Don't mess up the order or it will just not work. Then put the size block in the first one and in the third one. Here put the size you want to reach to, like we are 100, we need to reach 120, so I'll put here 120. And in the last one, you can just put the speed of the animation and also the smoothness, so like 3 is the perfect value. Then you can just put it here and duplicate this and put it in else. Now we need to go back to size 100 when we are not touching the cookie, so you can just put here 100. And when you click the green flag, you can see when I hover mouse over the cookie, it expands, like it increases its size. And when you just hover your mouse away, it will go back to 100, and that works really good. Now we need to make it like it should detect our clicks and change the score by 1. So to do that, first of all, make the variable score, and you can just put your set score to 0. Now we'll detect the click. So just put here if mouse down, wait until not mouse down, then if touching mouse pointer. Now the script I put in this will be the thing that happens when we click on the cookie. So now we can just put here change score by 1, and as you can see, when I start clicking, it will change the score by 1. But the clicking doesn't look really that good, because when we are clicking, nothing is actually being animated, like the cookie is just there and it does not move at all. So to fix that and put an actually really good clicking effect, you can just duplicate this block and put it here, and instead of 100, put here 80. And now when we play it, you can see there is a really good clicking animation. Now this is working, but as you know, in clicker games we do have a lot of upgradable options like score per click or score per second. So in this case, we'll just work with score per click. So you can just make a variable called score per click. You can just put here change score by score per click, and here you can put set score per click to 1. So like if it is 1, so it will change by 1, and if I set it to 5, you can see it is changing it by 5, which can be useful further in the series. Now we are done with clicking. Let's move on to the glowing animation. So to do that, you can just start with when the green flag clicked, hide, because we are working with the broadcast. You can just put here when I receive start game, switch to costume 1, go to back layer and show. Now we need to go to the player and rotate the glow 2 degrees. You can just put here forever, go to cookie and turn 2 degrees. You can see it is working, but it looks really big. So we can just change the size like to 75 maybe, and now it looks fine. And also it is really bright. So you can also like add some ghost effects. So set ghost effect to 35. And as you can see, it is looking much better now. Now you can see when I play it, it is really smooth and works really well. And the glow is also looking really good. Now we'll make the falling cookie animation. And here also we'll start the same way, like when the green flag clicked, hide, when I receive start game. And yeah, we'll work now. Now this will go like, first there will be the sprite, then the clones will appear and it will be a continuous animation. So to start it, you can just put here like basic stuff, like go to back layer and show. We are putting it back layer because we want it at the very back of the game. We don't want it to interrupt our gameplay. So you can just put here, go to back layer and show. Also switch to costume 1. Now you can just put here, go to X0 and Y0 and then repeat 72 times, change Y by -5. Now I have specifically used these values just because 72 into 5 is 360, and there are a lot of combinations like 180 into 2, that is also 360, but the speed here is really good, like it is -5, not -2. So I think these values are really good. Now once we do that, like you can see here, it just moves all the way down. As soon as we start, we need a clone above this so that the animation is continuous. So you can just put above this, create clone of myself. And when I start as a clone, just go to X0 and Y360. So it will be just exactly above this. And then you can just duplicate the script and put it here. Repeat 72, change Y -5. But when you do this, you can see it starts from up and goes in the center. So we need to do this 2 times. You can just duplicate this again and put it here. So as you can see, it will go all the way from up to all the way down, like below the screen. So that works. Now we need this continuously, like it is just creating one clone. So we need to keep creating clones. So when it hits the center, we can just put here create clone of myself. And now when we start, you can see there is a continuous falling of cookies, but it is too bright. So you can just put here set ghost effect to whatever you like. I'll just put here 75 because it is really bright, and just put it here in the when I receive start game script, and you can see it is much better now. There is a minor problem, like when I pause the game, you can see this is the intersection of two clones and we don't want this to happen. So we can just put here, go to X0 and Y-35 in the when I receive start game thing, and when you play it now, there's no clone intersection. Now this one looks really smooth, but as you can see, we have something here visible. We don't want this. So you can just put here hide and that will fix it. Like you can see, this animation looks really good now. And the last thing is the bars. Now this one is really easy to make, and we will not use the when I receive start game for this because this will be in the start menu as well. So we can just put here when the green flag click forever, go to front layer. And also you can just put here show. And now you can see when we play it, this is our working clicker game. But this is really bare bones now, and we'll add a lot of stuff in this series. Stay tuned for the next part and I'll see you there. Thank you for watching.